Hi, hello, Yakis here. Today is a very important video. I want to showcase the bugs that are present in the blueprint designers that we will introduce with Satisfactory 1.0. These are 5x5 and 6x6 blueprint designers. Also, I will showcase some minor issues, and I will probably talk about the discrepancies that can be improved upon. But first of all, the bugs. I'm not trying to trash the game. I enjoy Satisfactory. Pretty obvious. I have like more than 50 videos on my channel about that, and probably 40 of them are about the blueprint designer. So, let's go into the topic. Alright, the major bugs. 5x5 and 6x6 blueprint designers, they are not cubes. You could not build to the fullest volume of the blueprint designers. In the case of machinery and things like conveyor lift elevators and conveyor lift halls and probably like anything that is logistics aside the belts and pipes itself. So over here is the example of 6x6 blueprint designer. We have the structure inside up to the upmost level, and here in the middle I can build the assembler. It's pretty much on the edge of the upper limit, but it is only the case for the 4x4 core. If I go for the sides, well, yeah, the collision hitbox does not allow to build anything. So basically we have like 4x4 core that is fine, probably they stretch the 4x4 blueprint designer just fine, but when they increase the volume of the blueprint designer by one step and one step for the 6x6, they sort of like messed up those collision boxes for the machinery. So it is fine if I go lower, but at certain point I just hit the collision box of the blueprint designer and I'm not able to build anything there on the edges, which is like the upper level of the blueprint designer. So this is not the cube, this is like fake. And the biggest issue, like machinery, I can work with that, like it's kind of fine, but the major hurdle is the interconnected blueprints, the modular blueprints, when you try to bring things together from upper blueprint, like for example you're making the skyscraper and you want to bring the conveyor elevators down from the previous blueprint. So here we have the example. So I want to bring this socket over there, and this is sort of like the connection to the next blueprint, so I want to stack those blueprints. And if I try to go and grab like conveyor lift over here, the game doesn't allow to construct the conveyor lift up here because there is a collision hitbox that doesn't allow to make that. The belts are fine, so I end up actually doing this bizarre thing that I'm bringing up the belt over here. This is like the lowest limit where I can actually make the conveyor lift elevator, and then I sort of like funnel it where I want it to be. Next up is a small issue of not clipping, more of like overlapping and angles in the blueprint designer, so we cannot really work with the walls anymore when it comes to 45 degree angles at the edge of the blueprint designer. I was doing, this is a like 4x4 blueprint from the update 8 era, and I could not really do it anymore in Satisfactory 1.0, it is not possible. So yeah, I could not do those angles, it's not possible. Why? Well, as you can see over here, I've done the similar thing, so I can add the wall over here. But when I try to extend those angled walls over here, I could not do that because, well, I have overlap with the blueprint designer edge. And it's kind of funny because the collision box of the wall, it is in the middle, that center. And you can do things like this and save the blueprint and it would be fine. Actually, it's kind of really powerful tool to make something interesting when it comes to exterior design. For example, over there, I'm doing the fuel factory, the fuel power plant, and I'm making the shaft that is using this technique. So this is like a 5x5 blueprint, but I have those walls that are sort of like extending, like what it is, like 2 meters or 3 meters up front. So this is like a very powerful tool, but the angles, I could not really do angles anymore as I was making them in update 8. And now I need to use crutches, and those crutches are pretty much, well, let's cover the edge with the metal beam, you know? Small issue, but still there. Alright, the next issue is all about the assembler. So previously we could build the assembler on the edge of the blueprint designer like that. Now the collision box of the assembler is different for no particular reason. And this is like the furthest that you can put the assembler. This results in the old blueprints that can be no longer flush together. So yeah, if you can see over here, I have the blueprints from the update 8, where I have the assemblers pretty much on the edge. This is how you can make the manifolds. So it's the legit thing to do. Like this was in the game pretty much from the update 5. But when it comes to the blueprint designer, you could not use this technique. You need to have the assembler pretty much further down into the Blueprint Designer. You could not really make this anymore, so this is not the issue going upward, but everything done during update 8 is now basically, yeah, screw you, you could not put this blueprint together. Small issue, but still there. I don't know, should it be addressed or not, you know, like, leave the comment down below. But yeah, I have like a couple of those blueprints that are no longer workable together, unfortunately. Next one is all about conveyor poles. So you could not really place conveyor poles inside of the collision box of the machinery anymore. It was not the case for the update 8, so this is weird. This is something that changed, and it's kind of sort of funny because, yeah, conveyor poles, stuck them inside of the machinery, nobody cares. But when it comes to conveyor poles, for some bizarre reason, we were limited. Blueprints usually use something more compact. This is more of like a prominent issue when it comes to the Blueprint Designer, not the game itself. Also, I'm making Satisfactory Q&A topic for this particular video. This is basically the video that I would be linking in the topic, aside while describing the main issues there in text form. Please upload that, because I think like majority of my audience is sort of like Blueprint geeks, and they love the Blueprint Designer, and probably they would enjoy if the Blueprint Designer would be better. But now I want to talk about the discrepancies and quality of life issues that can be addressed with the Blueprint Designer. The UI of Blueprints, well, it's workable, but it is not great. Especially if when you are making a lot of Blueprints, you will handle a lot of issues and you want to keep in mind a lot of things that are not really necessary. First of all, we have two more Blueprint Designers in Satisfactory 1.0 and they are not cross-compatible, so you'll fail to load the Blueprint into a different Blueprint Designer. And this is an issue. So there are the workaround to that. For example, you can put 4x4 into the name, but then the naming, the names of the Blueprints, they are limited, they are short. So if you are putting something like 4x4, then some sort of like characteristic like Blueprint A, Blueprint B, you know, sometimes I do that for the modular blueprints or for the rail supports, I'm doing the length, the height, sorry, the height of the blueprint, for example, 40 meters over here. Then I'm putting rail, so I can search for the rail in the search when I'm searching for the rail. Then I'm putting, for example, curve there, because when I'm searching for the curves, I want to see the curves. So I have like five characteristics of the blueprint in the name, just to search for particular things when I'm doing a lot of things with the blueprints. And then I have like probably like three letters left to name the blueprint. This is like ridiculous, to be honest. So yeah, either the naming should be longer or we should have some sort of like sorting system, at least for different types of the Blueprint Designers. For example, we can have those like toggles somewhere on the edge of the UI where you can select all 4x4 blueprints or all 5x5 or all 6x6 blueprints, or maybe even have like the toggle for the modded blueprints. You know, there are like bigger Blueprint Designers, make the generic toggle for those. That would be useful as well. Like, you know, the mod compatibility. Oh man, this word. Yeah, I could not say this word. Don't even try. Next issue is the UI. We can put some sort of like notification dongle there on somewhere on the corner of those icons. For example, for Mark 1 Blueprint Designer, we can have like red circle with letter 1. For Mark 2, we can have red circle, letter 2. Mark 3, letter 3. All right, so the funniest thing just happened when I was recording two last bits about the Blueprint Designers and the UI for them. The game just crashed and we had a new update. So some bizarre reason my game crashed when the update was out. I don't know how it happened, but OBS also crashed. So I don't know, is this the OBS crashing the game, or this is the patch actually going out, crashing the game and crashing the OBS? This is bizarre. So yeah, the things happened. I will go over this update. Probably I will look up for things that can be in this video and leave out them when I would be editing this video. But there is like the last thing that I want to talk about regarding the Blueprint Designers, and this is the progressions of the new Blueprint Designers. First of all, I would say that 5x5 and 6x6 Blueprint Designers is in that golden spot. They are really usable. When it comes to 4x4 Blueprint Designer that I was using during update 8 for month on end, it's just garbage. Like, it's bad. It's too small, really. I could really do a lot of things when it comes to Blueprint Factories with the 4x4. It's too limited. And when you are talking about like generic, normal, satisfactory player, they would be probably really, really, really annoyed by 4x4 blueprint designer. I think there should be only two blueprint designers in the game, and they should be 5x5 and 6x6. Like, this is my honest opinion. I think like one extra blueprint designer, which is not really usable for the majority of the game, well, it should not be the case. There should be only two. Not like only one, like Highlander, there should be only one. No, there should be two. So the progression should be there. And regarding the progression, dude, like tier 9 Mark III blueprint designer, it's not the gameplay progression, it's just torture. Because blueprint designer is more of a creativity tool, and when you are looking creativity tool behind the gameplay progression, and when this is like very, very late game progression, it doesn't really make a lot of sense. But this is more of like my taste for the gameplay in the Satisfactory. Probably I'm not playing the game as majority of people. I really hope this video was helpful for the developers. I hope that the game would be improved upon and we'll enjoy even more better things in Satisfactory. And until next time, thank you very much for watching. Have a nice one, and Yakis is out.